Today we continue our season previews with Dallas Stars. And Dallas reached Stanley Cup final last season, but we're not able to beat Tampa Bay in those games. They won two, but out of six, Tampa took a cup to the Florida. How do you see, Tommy? Is it standard for Texas in the future that Dallas will reach playoffs and Stanley Cup final year after year now when they opened a path for that kind of performance?
Yeah, it could be, but it's been a very roller coaster type of team. So they've been in and out of playoffs. The core players are a bit aging, so their window is around now. So they should do fine. Of course, last season was divided in two. They were they finished fourth, but they were playing really, really badly in the end after Jim Montgomery had to leave due to personal reasons. So they only won two of their last 11 games before the season was called off. And then, of course, in the playoffs, they found their stride and went all the way to the final, which was a big surprise for everyone because everyone was expecting them to continue as bad as they had in the regular season. But this time around, it's interesting to see how they will do. How have we been doing with the predictions of the Stars last season?
So Dallas has been a bit over average team during the last three seasons. Like you said, they've had good times and not so great times. And home, they have won 57.5% of their games, on the road 48%. So those are a bit better than average team in NHL. Our predictions have been quite accurate, especially at home. Of all the 60% of the home games, there has been positive expected value in the games, and out of those games, over 60% have been correct. And that has resulted almost 800 profit out of those three seasons, if you would bet based on our simulations. Another interesting topic is that on the road, they have played so-so in many cases, but especially at home, those back-to-back games, the second or third game in a row, have been very successful. So they have been able to win over 60% of those games, and it looks like teams, visiting teams, are enjoying Dallas, and they cannot play the second game so well as home team will do. So that is something to keep in mind when Dallas is playing those back-to-back games at this season. There will be quite a few. But overall, I think Dallas has been, in game-wise, good team. How do you see the matchup with the new teams in division? Are they ready to rock with those teams, or is there some bad matchups for the Stars?
Definitely some changes to Stars' schedule now. They are facing their former rivals, of course. Nashville and Chicago are still in the same division. But there is now the Eastern Conference teams, the upcoming Carolina Hurricanes, of course, and then their counterpart from the finals, Tampa Bay Lightning as well. So there will be some sort of rivalry going on between these two for sure. It's hard to say what sort of matchup will they provide for the Stars, because we're not entirely sure which sort of Stars team will show up now with Rick Bowness starting his first full season. Well, it's not a full season, but first regular season with the Stars. And of course, the core players, Joe Pavelski, Jamie Benn, are once again a bit older. So they need to be doing a lot better than they actually did last year in the regular season already. So the veterans need to take charge for sure. And of course, the defense will then need to lead the way under Rick Bowness. But that remains to be seen how they are going to play. But how about our predictions? Are there any nice matchups according to the statistics?
They have been playing quite even with these many teams like you said, old rivals like Nashville or Chicago have been around 50%. Detroit has been a bit lower level team, and Dallas have been able to win 60% of those games. But there's no big big difference in those, let's say, teams that they have faced quite a few times. Last season, the final naturally changed Tampa numbers, so that Tampa has won every two of the three games, so there is only 33% win percentage for Dallas. But Columbus Blue Jackets hasn't been able to win Dallas at all in five games they faced during the last three seasons. So maybe that is something to look if Dallas' playing style would match the grinding of the Columbus and their speed with youngsters who are coming, and the experience from the old veterans would be good matchup against the Columbus. One other betting related stat that is worth to note is the totals bet. So overall during the last three seasons, if you would bet totals in every game based on our simulations, you would end up winning almost 2,200. So well, that is pure profit, not wins, but profit. So total, we have been able to predict very accurately.
That's good to hear. And let's have a look at those matchup when the season starts and keep an eye out on the trend as well. Dallas roster hasn't gone through a lot of changes this season. They're going pretty much with the same group they had in the playoffs. Ben Bishop, the, well, number one goaltender to start with, but number two goaltender to start the season now, is out for about a month at least. But it was Anton Khudobin who led them in the playoffs anyway, so he will be there to guard the net. Tyler Seguin is also out until April, so the offense is a little bit hindered by that for sure. Of course, now what we saw in the playoffs was that Dallas had their defense joining the offense a lot more than previously. So these young guys, Miro Heiskanen, John Klingberg, even Esa Lindell took a lot of role offensively to ease the burden on the top line of Alex Radulov and Jamie Benn and Tyler Seguin. So it's again something to see how Bowness will do with this sort of thing. Will he go all-out attack, or will he play more more conservative with his defense especially? There is a lot of defensive prowess as well. Like I said, Esa Lindell took a little bit offensive role as well, but he's better defensively. There is Jamie Oleksiak, Andrei Sekera, definitely more of a defensive kind of player. So defense is quite in a good shape overall in Dallas. For the offense, the tip of the spear is really good. It's Jamie Benn, Seguin, and Radulov are, of course, great players. Denis Gurianov broke through last season in the playoffs, so you can expect, well, normal season, I would expect 30 goals, but this season, a little bit less, but 20 goals is all doable. Roope Hintz is the Finnish guy, very good two-way forward, also produces points. So there is a lot of depth, but maybe lacking a little bit of this sort of secondary scoring type that you could trust if the first line of those big guns can't deliver. Of course, Joe Pavelski, I forgot to mention, is always there, but his production has been down a bit, so he needs to step up like the other guys in the offense. There was only Tyler Seguin who scored 50 points last season in 69 games. So it's a disappointing season in the regular season, of course.
But so you don't think that Joel Kiviranta will continue to his stride what he did against the Colorado Avalanche in playoffs? So in game 7, 3 goals, overtime goal, game winner. So that kind of performance would, of course, improve the Dallas secondary scoring.
Yeah, that would definitely, but it doesn't show up in our simulations yet, so he has to do something for a couple of games more, and then we'll see. But that's the sort of stuff that Dallas will definitely need, because they are pretty much relying on the top line. usually. And like we saw last season, that if they fail, Dallas will have miserable time. So Jamie Benn scored 39 points in 69 games. So that's just not acceptable for a player of his caliber. How about the season predictions? Have we been anywhere in the ballpark with Stars?
So last season, we predicted them to be sixth and reach the playoffs. It was pretty much aligned what Vegas set up for the points line. 69.5 was line. We predicted 96.5. We predicted 96. And in the shortened season, they actually got 82 points out of 69 games. So it would be pretty much same number what was predicted. But like you said, they were not playing very great in the regular season, especially end of it. So it could be that our prediction was correct. Then 2 years ago, our prediction was that they would be fifth and going over 94.2 lines points in the Vegas line, and the result was that they were sixth. They got 93, so again very close of that number, but on the wrong side. And 3 years ago they slumped quite a bit because we predicted them to win the Western Conference, reach 110 points and clearly over the line of 97, but they were not able to reach even playoffs, and their points was reasonably close of the line. They got 92 points, but like I said, the performance drop was quite a bit compared to earlier years and years after this one. How about this time? What kind of bets for a Stanley Cup win or even divisional win you can get from the bookmakers?
Yeah, well, the Stars are second favorites to win the Stanley Cup from their division. So they're quite high there, of course, because of last season's playoff run. That's understandable. Overall in the league, they are around 10th. There is a lot of teams with even or the same odds around their 10 to 14 or something like this. So they're not that much favored to win it. And of course, reaching the final is always something to keep an eye out. Like if they do the same as San Jose Sharks, that they reach the final and then fall very hard, or what's going to happen. So like we saw from the season predictions, that it's been a roller coaster of a team, that we've been sometimes a bit wrong with them as well. Right now we have them fourth in the division, which is, I think, is quite safe bet that they make a playoff run this time around as well, because their division is really divided in two. So there is four good teams and four, let's say, challengers. Then so winning those four lower teams will be enough for them to make the playoffs. But of course, it needs everyone to step up. It needs the goaltenders to keep playing as well as they did in the playoffs. They need the veterans to lead the line, and they need the defense to be able to provide such a support in offense as they did in the playoffs. But if they do play like they did in the end of the regular season, it'll be a very short season this time again for Stars.
Yeah, let's see what kind of points total bookmakers will give next week, and we'll check how far our numbers are. But I have also a kind of feeling that if the total line is very high, it would be somehow safe to bet them under in this case, because new teams, Tampa and others, are a bit tougher matchup than those West teams that Dallas have been playing in the past.
Yeah, that is something to keep an eye out. Let's see how the line will form when we get it.
Very good. We'll check it out and place a bet if line is good.
That will do.